It's been more than a month since a murder put the St. Matthews community on edge. On November the 23rd, employee Jack Combs was shot after closing the Kroger store inside the Woodlawn Shopping Center. Police are still searching for any solid leads in this case. WLKY's Colin Mayfield went to St. Matthews to see what business owners have to say and what they've heard over the last month.
It's been a month and 3 days since Jack Combs was killed at this Kroger store in St. Matthews, and police here are still searching for answers.
You know, I hope, as I think everybody else does here, that they find the guy or guys or whoever did this, because, I mean, it just doesn't make any sense.
On November 23rd, Jack Combs walked out of this Kroger to his car in a parking lot behind the store, only to be shot in the chest seconds later. We spoke to St. Matthews police today, who say they continue to investigate leads, but so far have not made any arrests. It has Brian Ullum and a lot of other customers asking the same question, why?
I think people are concerned. It's a nice area here. Mr. Bolin does a nice job with the shopping center, so it's a real shame.
Poe's Pet Depot has been in the Woodlawn Shopping Center almost a year. Co-owner Rob Poe tells us that he's heard the same uncertainty from customers that come into his store.
Anytime you have a murder right next door to you, it does waver you a little bit.
And the safety concerns have also shaken employees.
Especially from the fact that, you know, you get this back parking lot that all of these store owners use. Okay, now it's lit. They do have lights back there. But at the same time, you're walking out into a dark back parking lot.
But in an attempt to ease fears, there is and will continue to be an increased police presence in the area.
Well, we've seen a lot of police presence, whether they're driving through. I've had several of them just walk through the store, talk to us, try to keep us calm.
A $30,000 reward is still on the table for any information on this case leading to an arrest. In St. Matthews, I'm Colin Mayfield, WLKY News.
All right, Colin. Now, if you have any information on this case, you are urged to call St. Matthews authorities. That number is 502-899-2535.